Did you just say something about a victory Monday? Didn't you say 100-0?
Look, I can make a pick. People get so confused. I can make a pick. First of all, I was being facetious, obviously. But I can make a pick and, like, you know, still want the Browns to be successful and be excited when they are. Like, because I said I thought they'd lose the game, it means that I'm not allowed to celebrate the win? That's some of the dumbest logic I've ever heard in my entire life.
100-0. That's what Aaron said.
100-0 what?
49ers. I took some sexy photos yesterday. Come here.
Oh.
31-10. That's what you said.
Why are we doing this?
You're the only one that picked the Browns to win.
Damn right I did.
17-13?
Feels so good.
That's going to be a drop.
Probably should be. Should be. Someone told me that I need to walk in here doing the Conor McGregor, so.
Okay.
Come right out.
Chill, bro.
Come on.
You're so fast.
This is what we do. I'm so fast.
Oh. he didn't know what to say.
Hey. What did I tell you? Didn't I tell you the Browns would win? I just want to go on the record.
Yeah.
Come on, vouch for
you. Vouch for you.
Can I real quick interrupt? No,
24-10.
Yeah.
100-0.
Can I shut up. Can I real quick just say something, which is people think I'm not really a Browns fan, right? I fanduled a $25 bet, okay? So I had like $50 riding on San Francisco winning that game by 5 or more points. And I was rooting my butt off for the Browns. I'm willing to pay for the Browns to be successful and win. I'm willing to give my FanDuel, hard-earned FanDuel cash away.
Is anyone buying this?
I'm telling you, look, am I tried and true? No. Do I love the Broncos more? Yes. But if you don't think I don't wear brown and orange or whatever, I do. Yeah. What?
He was still talking. I was hoping you guys had something for me about being a Browns fan.
Right now? Yeah. If we're going to say Nick was the only person to get this right, let's also acknowledge the fact that Nick was the only person that picked the Tennessee Titans. The Tennessee Titans, led by Ryan Tannehill, to beat the Browns. So if we're going to talk 49ers, let's talk Titans as well.
Jealousy.
He's got a point.
He's batting 500. Congrats.
Hey, I'll take it. I'll take 500 all day.
RJ?
I think that they're both right.
I hope they all win.
What's up?
See ya. You like my shirt? You like my... What was that? What's up, home slice?
Yeah, all the players are wearing that.
Yeah.
Where'd you get that?
A little chub. AWOC gave it to me.
That's good.
Yeah. Cool. Well, I hope you have a good rest of the week. When are you coming in next?
Friday.
See you there. NFL Roundtable. Victory Monday?
Yay.
So I'm on my way in and they're playing the Stefanski video. And
what was the Stefanski video?
So he's asking the players, like, hey, we won, like, do you guys want off tomorrow? And then one of the players just like screams, Victory Monday. And they play the soundbite on RBS. And then Riz was like, you know, I think we actually coined the phrase Victory Monday. What? People have been saying that for 70 years.
So did you know that Riz came up with the phrase Victory Monday?
Oh, yeah. Absolutely, man. I mean, it goes back to...
70 years or so?
Something like that, yeah. Yeah, no question about it. Victory Monday and the OG Red Special.
So I heard that you came up with the term Victory Monday.
Well, Joe B., by the way, backs me up on that, Aaron. He just texted me during the show. He goes, absolutely. He goes, you guys were calling it Victory Monday 15 years ago. There's no one in America.
So I don't know. Maybe someone, like teams, would call it Victory Monday, but the fans celebrating Victory Monday?
No, we coined the phrase, I believe, or at least helped coin the phrase Victory Monday. Now everybody uses it, which is fine. Which is fine.
We should have copyrighted whatever.
Yeah, I should have saved all my baseball cards, too, when I was a kid.
So I think you were one of two people that actually had the Browns winning over
correct.
The weekend.
Me and Nick Paul were the only people that picked the Browns, correct.
How are you feeling about it?
Always good. Every Browns victory is good. Every single one. You know what? We're on to Indianapolis. That's what it is.
But I told you all preseason, Deshaun's going to play good in November and December. Give him a couple of weeks. Nobody wanted to hear him. I expect him to be back on Sunday.
Me, my sources are telling me the same thing.
Are they playing? What's going on? Are they playing Men in Black right now?
They're playing Men in Black right now.
For a little weird time with the whole Will and Jada thing, huh?
Yeah, but you know they're married, so it's cool. But they're not really married, so it's kind of cool too.
Did you get me this bag of candy?
I got you a bag of candy.
What?
Kind of candy?
The good stuff.
Don't either.
You don't get trick or treaters?
Never get trick or treaters.
So.
But I buy plenty of candy.
You just buy me. You just buy me.
Candy's so good, but I have a new thing. I don't like it frozen, but I like it in the fridge. I like it.
Oh, it's cool. Yeah, yeah. You can categorize scary movies and Halloween movies. What are your top two?
Ooh, man. Scary movies, Hereditary, creepy. A kid's head gets cut off in that movie. If you haven't seen it, I just spoiled it for you. As far as Halloween movies, Hocus Pocus. That's a classic.
Oh, that is good. That's really good, yeah.
Or Halloween Town. Another underrated classic.
Yes.
Yeah, we'll throw that.
All right, so we're going to categorize it as Halloween slash scary.
Okay,
so you...
now you're talking. When a Stranger Calls, When a Stranger Calls Back, the old ones.
Okay. Those are your top two?
That's what I'm going to go with.
Are those two different movies? When a Stranger Calls and When a Stranger...
It must be a sequel.
So the Stranger Called, and then they called back.
What's your top two?
I don't do...
No Halloween or scary? No spookies?
I don't do scary movies.
No spookies.
I don't do scary. You're looking at me like I'm crazy.
I'm a top thing. Why not be happy?
What did you grow up on Disney Channel with?
I didn't have cable when I was a kid.
Why not be scared?
Yeah, I had a rough childhood.
I literally want to hug you right now.
My J. Fox, when I was like 11 years old, scared the shit out of me. I don't even think that movie was scary. I think that movie was like a comedy. But it had the ghosts and it scared the shit out of me.
What was it?
No, it wasn't. It had some edge to it. The Frighteners with Michael J. Fox. RJ definitely knows about it. I will say, there is one genre, or there's one series that I like. Friday the 13th, Jason, for whatever reason, he doesn't scare me.
Yep.
Like, he seems like maybe a cool guy to hang out with. Whoa. After he's done after doing he's done his thing, you know, maybe have a beer. The mom freaked me out.
Well, I love the original, the classic ones, the Turner classic movies, like the Haunting original, the 13th Ghost original, and RJ, the movie critic, brought me this today. The Innocents, 1961. Black and white.
Top two Halloween and or scary movies.
The Craft from 1996 or 7.
Okay.
It's a cult classic. It's about witches, obviously. And Scream.
Oh, that's good. New? Original. Okay, OG. Love it. Hi, Jess.
Hi.
Top two Halloween and or scary movies.
Not for me.
Not for you?
No, I can do like Exorcist.
Oh, that's pretty, like, demonic.
Yeah, but not, like, Saw or, like, any of those, like, gross
ones.
No.
All right, so we have The Exorcist.
Yeah, but Dateline all day.
So so that's a good series. Good, oh, I'm very surprised Holly didn't say that.
Yeah. Just any time murder is pretty good. I'm a Dateline ambassador. So.
What does that mean? Do you get gear? Do you get paid? Or?
Yeah, I have Dateline socks.
That's how they paid you?
I'm a friend.
That's how they paid me, and they flew me to New York. And I got to enter the episode. I got to meet the whole cast.
Yeah, not scary movie guy. I'm not horror film guy because I watch the Browns every Sunday, okay?
That I've never been more excited about a quarterback finally meeting with the media. For $230 million, he's finally gracing us with his presence. Oh,
top two great. Scary movies and or Halloween movies.
The scariest movie I've ever seen is The Ring. I didn't sleep for a week after I saw it. And my second favorite scary movie is Get Out, a scary movie. It's kind of a thriller. I don't know.
It is a thriller.
I love that movie.
I thought you were going to say something Browns or QB related, but
well,
I gave you the option.
2017 Browns is the worst horror movie I've ever seen.
What's happening?
Top two, Halloween and or scary movie.
Halloween. I mean, it's a really, really good movie.
Okay, so that's one of two.
What are you talking about?
I need, like, a second one.
You need another Halloween movie?
Yeah.
That's good to watch?
Yeah.
Reanimator. Great movie. About a guy who develops a chemical to bring dead people back to life.
Oh.
And it goes crazy.
top two Halloween and or scary movies.
Well, first off, I hate scary movies just because...
Are you scared?
No, it's not even that. It's funny because, like, people always say it to me, but it's not even that. It's just, like, I don't think I've ever watched a scary movie and walked away from, like, wow, like, Oscar-worthy performance. You know what I mean? Like, it's all just corny, all right. Terrible acting, and I get that that's the thing. I will say the best scary movie that I've ever seen is also the most messed up movie I've ever seen is Rosemary's Baby. Hmm. Who's the dude? Producer back in the day, Once Upon a Time in Hollywood. Roman Polanski. He was the one that did that movie, and essentially it's this girl...
I didn't ask for analysis. Yeah. What's the second movie?
Second one would probably be 1408.
It was 1408.
It's like that haunted... it's a hotel room that's haunted. That was a really good movie. Am I allowed to swear on this?
Yeah.
Like, can I drop an F-bomb? Because I wanted to tell the story about when I told my dad that I watched Rosemary's Baby and what his reaction was.
Go.
You have 10 seconds. I told my dad, I was like, this movie was so messed up. My dad was excited. I was like, why are you watching that fucked up shit?
All right, top two.
All right, top twos. Well, I'll say this, like a movie that really, really, back in the day, like scared the hell out of me is It. Like, I don't know.
Yeah.
And I ain't even scared of clowns, man, but that thing is weird. And after that, like, I don't know, man. I mean, you know what? I'll go Freddy, Nightmare on Elm Street 2.
All right, so what'd you say?
I would recommend a movie called Reanimator. It's from the, I believe, the late 80s, early 90s.
So are you just redoing this?
Yeah, I'm just redoing it because what did you ask me last time? You came up to me and you were like, Halloween, scary movie, what's it on?
Top two, Halloween and or scary movie. No, I was like, what's your favorite Halloween and or scary movie?
What's my favorite Halloween and or scary movie? Well, my favorite Halloween or scary movie is The Evil Dead.
Okay.
1979, 1981, I think, maybe. Directed by a guy who dropped out of college and just decided to make a horror movie. And boy, did he make a horror movie. It's available anywhere. There's a million sequels to it. They just had one last year called Evil Dead Rise, which you can watch on HBO. It's a great scary movie. Made with almost no money, but a lot of spirit.
Oh, those are the best.
Yeah, there's nothing to it. I mean, I guess if you look at it now, it's kind of a hokey movie, and it isn't as scary as people thought it was back then. But it sure scared me when I popped it in the machine the first time I saw it at midnight by myself. It got me pretty good and scared.
You're great in spirit.
Am I great in spirit? You're great in spirit, Rob. And so is David. And Rizzy's good and great in spirit.
Great in spirit. Whoa! What are you doing?
I'm going into the hot take lab.
What?
No, I thought I was impressed with PJ Walker.
But
has anyone out there thought that the Browns might be just better off with Pete? I'm ushering in the PJ Walker.
Is that what you're tweeting
right now? You're ready for the start of the PJ Walker era? If he wins the Super Bowl as Browns quarterback, I want this video to play on SportsCenter, and I want everybody to know that it starts. Wait, watch this.
ladies and gentlemen, you just saw the art of a troll tweet by one Aaron Goldhammer, because and this is what like X Twitter, whatever you want to call it, all about is people will send these ridiculous, and then he's looking at how mad the replies are. That tells you exactly
he's fishing for this.
Fished for your replies and y'all fell for it. So Aaron wins.